Sandy Hook School. Callers indicating she thinks there's someone shooting in the building.
A police operator relayed the unfolding horror as armed SWAT teams entered the school.
Okay, these units in the school, I got bodies here.
Witnesses say gunshots had rung out over the school tannoy, prompting teachers to lock their classrooms and order terrified children to hide under desks and in cupboards.
We kept hearing gun noises and put your hands up, and we just kept hearing that.
But while appearing calm, teachers were fearing the worst.
I'm thinking that I have to almost be their parent. Like, I have to tell them, you know. So I said to them, I said, I need you to know that I love you all very much and that it's going to be okay, because I thought that was the last thing they were ever going to hear. I thought we were all going to die.
Dawn Hochsprung was the head teacher. She was shot dead after going to investigate the noise together with Mary Sherlock, the school's psychologist, who was also killed. 27-year-old Victoria Soto taught some of the youngest children and is reported to have died trying to shield them. There is a second crime scene, the taped-off family home in which the gunman killed his own mother. Police have identified the killer as 20-year-old Adam Lanza, described by schoolmates as bright but withdrawn and socially awkward, perhaps with a personality disorder. Inside his house, the police found evidence which they say gives a sense of the gunman's motive.
Our investigators at the crime scene, the school, and secondarily at the secondary crime scene that we discussed where the female was located deceased did produce some very good evidence in this investigation that our investigators will be able to use in hopefully painting the complete picture as to how and, more importantly, why this occurred.
It occurred in a picture postcard New England town that until yesterday prided itself on being safe, even dull. The kind of place where everyone had a connection to the local school.
When I was a kid,
Kelly Sullivan had coached some of the children in athletics and attended the same church as one of those feared lost.
At the church service, the priest referenced one of the members of our parish, a little girl who is still unaccounted for, and next week she's supposed to be playing the angel in the Christmas Nativity. So that really shook all of us up, knowing that she's not accounted for right now.
Young lives taken in what should have been the sanctuary of a school, a sickening loss and a test of their faith.